I'm Teacher Emily. Today, I'm going to tell you a story, How Do You Feed a Hungry Giant? By Kathleen Friedman. My name is Oscar, and you're never going to believe what just happened to me. Seriously, you're not going to believe it.
You really aren't going to believe it.
I opened the door to let my dog, Cowgirl, out, and... I found a giant in my backyard! He was standing right there by the swings and the sandbox! Even though he scared me, he was a giant after all. He looked a little sad, but then he held up a sign that read,
Food, please.
And I realized he was just really hungry. Don't worry, giant. I will find you something to eat. What would a hungry giant want for lunch? Just the thing. I will bring him green grapes. Who doesn't like green grapes? He's pretty big, but three bunches of grapes should do the trick.
I don't think three bunches of grapes will fill up a giant, but who knows?
Eat up, giant! Seriously, you're not going to believe it. He ate all of the grapes in one big gulp. I guess it's back to the kitchen for me. Okay, here's some pizza left over from dinner last night. Everyone loves pizza. 10 slices should be enough to feed a hungry giant. Eat up, giant! Seriously, you're not going to believe this. He gobbled up the pizza in 1 second flat. I guess it's back to the kitchen for me. Here are 4 chicken quesadillas. I don't like them, but I bet he will. And he can wash them down with 15 big bottles of chocolate milk. Drink up, giant. Seriously, you're not going to believe this. He slurped it all up in the blink of an eye. It's back to the kitchen for me. I went to the pantry this time. Here is 33 jars of peanut butter and 2 bags of marshmallows, plus 12 of my favorite blueberry muffins. Good thing my dad just went shopping. Add up, giant! Seriously, you're not going to believe this. He ate it as quick as lightning. It's back to the kitchen for me. My mom made 200 chocolate chip cookies from my school's back cell. I'm sure no one will notice if I take a few to the giant. And maybe I will eat 1, 2, or 3 just to hold me over till dinner. That still leaves 197 for the giant and 2 for the back cell. Eat up, giant! Seriously, you're not going to believe this. He ate all those cookies like they were popcorn. It's back to the kitchen for me. Okay, this time I loaded up my wagon with everything I could find. 50 strawberry yogurts, my baby brother Mickey's cheese crackers, an orange from my lunch bag, a pot of Nana's world famous tomato soup, the last slice of carrot cake, 15 of those sticky rice balls our neighbor dropped off this morning, a bunch of bananas. And my dad's secret supply of after-dinner mints. I hope nobody notices the refrigerator is empty.
I hope nobody notices that I've helped myself to that slice of carrot cake.
Oh no! Here's my mom! She wants to know why I'm taking all the leftover food into the backyard. I pull her over to the window and she sees the hungry giant. She reads a sign. You are never going to believe what happened next. Seriously, you aren't going to believe it. My mom invited a hungry giant to dinner at our house.
More food, please.
She is even letting me help her cook.That's how you feed a hungry giant. The end. Thanks for watching and listening to the story. Goodbye.